I'll come back. Previously, we were discussing about identity ratios. That what are the cases that come from the activity ratios. Let's deal with some of the further cases and application level questions. That comes in the turnover ratios. Next page. You are given the following information relating to a company, whereby gross profit 2,40,000, gross profit ratio is 20%, stock turnover ratio is 5, average age of debtors is 1.5 months, average age of creditors is 1 month, the closing stock was rupees 10,000 more than the opening stock, calculate cost of sales, purchases, closing stock, sundry credit debtors on year ending means closing debtors as well as closing creditors. The peculiarity of the question is, here you are given various details. Usually in the previous question, you were asked to find all this information. But in this question, all these details are given and you are asked to find various other items that usually is given in the question as a part of finding out various ratios. So let's deal with this case. First of all, you need to find cost of sales. In order to find cost of sales, there are two equations. One is sales minus gross profit and other is opening stock plus purchases plus direct expenses minus closing stock. Since in the question already details regarding gross profit is given, and also there is another one, gross profit ratio is 20%, and previously we have discussed about this part. Whenever gross profit ratio is given, it means that gross profit is 20% of sales. Here gross profit is already given and gross profit ratio is given. From these two details or these two values, we can easily find sales. So gross profit ratio is gross profit by net sales into 100, which is already given as 20%. And in the question, it is also given that gross profit is 2,40,000, and it means that it is, means 2,40,000 is 20% of sales. So on the basis of that information, we can say that sales is 12 lakhs. I hope you understand the concept. Let's go through it. So cost of sales is equal to sales minus gross profit. 12 lakhs minus 2,40,000, you will 9,60,000. Now you have cost of sales. Next one, closing stock. The only detail or equation that relating to closing stock is average stock. We know that average stock is open stock plus closing stock divided by 2. But in the question, there is no information regarding opening stock or average stock. So you need to first of all need to find average stock, because there is no information regarding closing stock as well as opening stock. There is only information that closing stock is 10,000 more than opening stock. So in order to deal with this part, you need average stock. So let's deal with that part. We know that stock turnover ratio is cost of sales divided by average stock. Stock turnover ratio is already given in the question, that is 5. Cost of sales, which we have found previously, 960,000 divided by average stock. By using mathematical steps, you will get average stock is 1,92,000. Now in the question, it is said that closing stock is 10,000 more than opening stock. So closing stock is 10,000 more than opening stock. We have dealt that part in the previous sessions. So let's assume that opening stock is X and closing stock is X plus 10,000. And we know that average stock is opening stock plus closing stock divided by 2. And average stock is 1,92,000, which we found out just now. 192,000 equal x. Opening stock is x plus closing stock is x plus 10,000 whole divided by 2. You will get 192,000 equal to 2x plus 10,000, because here the plus, there is a plus sign in the front of the bracket. So once we saw that sign, you can open the bracket, then the plus into x will come, x plus 10,000, and x will be the, remains the same. So 2x plus 10,000 whole divided by 2. Finally, x equal to 187,000. We assume that opening stock is x, so the value of opening stock is 187,000. And we also assume that closing stock is x plus 10,000. Here x is 187,000. So 187,000 plus 10,000, you will get 197,000. So now you have the value of closing stock. Next is purchases. In the question, there is no information regarding purchases is given. So let's think about the where or in which equation where purchases comes. The only detail or equation in which purchases come is cost of sales. In the equation of cost of sales, there are two equations for finding cost of sales. In one of the equation, there is purchases. There is closing stock here. Cost of sales or cost of goods sold is can be found out by using the equation opening stock plus purchases plus direct expenses minus closing stock. Since in that equation we have cost of sales, opening stock and closing stock, the equation can be converted into like this. So purchases equal to cost of sales plus closing stock minus opening stock. We have cost of sales 960,000, closing stock is 197,000 and opening stock is 187,000. Finally you will get 970,000. Next one, you are asked to find sundry debtors on 31/12. It means closing debtors. The only detail given in the question is average age of debtors is 1.5 months. And we know the equation for finding the average age of debtors. So we will begin with that equation. Average age of debtors is 1.5 months. It is already given in the question. And we know that average age of debtors is closing debtors divided by credit sales into time. The equation is time divided by debtors turnover ratio. The same equation can be written as like this: closing stock divided by credit sales into time. Average age of debtors is 1.5 months. Closing debtors, we don't know, you are asked to find, divided by credit sales is 12 lakhs. And here the time is 12 because the average age of debtors is given in months. So you need to use the concept 12 months. So finally you will get closing debtors is 12 lakhs divided by, into 1.5 divided by 12, you will get 150,000. Next one, sundry creditors as on 31/12/2015. Similarly, which we have done previously in the debtors. Here the debtors, closing debtors, you are asked to find closing debtors. And in the question, it is the only detail given in regarding debtors is average age of debtors. Similar case, your creditors also, the only detail given is average age of creditors, that is 1 month. Similarly, we can use the same equation, average age of creditors equal to closing creditors divided by credit purchases into time. So 1 means which is already given in the question, any creditors, 1 equal to closing creditors, which we are to find, divided by credit purchases, which we already found here, 970,000 into time, you will get closing creditors is 80,833. So you may come across questions like this where ratios will be given. You need to find some other details that may be specified in the question on the basis of ratios. So whenever you are given the ratios and you need to find some other details, don't get confused. Just remember the equation which you have learned whenever the details of any of the ratios is given, definitely the answering has to be done, or the answer has to be begin from exactly that ratios itself. When a Stock-Turner ratio is given, it is implied that you need to use Stock-Turner ratio equation to find out all other items that are given in that equation or the details given in the question. So just go through all these details, make familiarize it, all these application level questions and all these methods which we have dealt now, just go through it. If you have any doubts or clarification in these questions, just contact me. That's all for today. Thank you.